Hello everyone, my name is Oeun. I'm really delighted to come here in order to teach you grammar lessons. I have a lot of grammar lessons for you guys. Anyway, have you watched my latest video yet? What was it about? It was about simple sentences, but declarative sentences. Simple sentences are divided into four types. One, declarative sentences, and number two is imperative sentences. So in today's video, you are going to learn imperative sentences of simple sentences with me. You are going to learn the two more sentences of simple sentences in the following videos. Let's get started. Sentences. Number one, simple sentences. Letter A, about declarative sentences. And letter B, about imperative sentences. What is an imperative sentence? An imperative sentence gives commands or make requests. It sounds like someone order somebody to do something. Here, it command mean like that. So, someone order somebody to do something is like that. Look at the example. Come back. When you say that, come back. What is it? Is it full stop or exclamation mark? It is an exclamation mark. Okay. Do be reasonable. It is full stop. Don't ever do that again. Or you say, don't ever do that again. An exclamation mark. Come and have a cup of tea. Full stop. Sit up straight. An exclamation mark. Mind your own business. An exclamation mark. In imperative, someone orders somebody to do something. Where is subject? In imperative sentences, we already know that subject is you. So you is deleted. It is called hidden subject. Actually, you can write, you come back. But when you write, you come back, it is not an imperative sentence. An imperative sentence usually begins with base form verb. Subject has already been known. Actually, it is the second person. Who is the second person? You. You is called hidden subject. Come back. You come back, in fact. Don't be reasonable. When if you are not using an imperative sentence, you say, you are reasonable. Don't ever do that again. You don't ever do that again if it's a simple sentence or if it's a declarative sentence. Come and have a cup of tea. You come and have a cup of tea if it's a declarative sentence. Sit up straight. You sit up straight. Mind your own business. You mind your own business if it is a declarative sentence. Okay. According to the example, and you can see the mark in here, the like question or full stop and exclamation mark like this, we can write it formulas. I already talked about hidden subject. Actually, all here we have it subject called hidden subject, you, the second person. So you can write the formula like this. You know, why some sentences end with full stop and why other with an exclamation mark? Well, let me tell you something. Basically, imperative sentence end with full stop. But if you want to show that the words are being spoken with great force or emotion, then use an exclamation mark like this. Okay? So its formula is, Phi. Phi means the hidden subject you already mentioned, so it means that imperative sentence no subject be formed. Object, or you can write complement. Okay. Or you can see this one, it is also compound verb. You can write in two ways. It is base form là an base form. Complement. In place of an here, you can write or sometimes, but or is not really common in this use. Okay, and but or is also possible. Again, imperative sentence refer to a sentence that give command or make request. When you use imperative sentence, it sounds like someone order somebody to do something. Okay, in our imperative sentence we can use two marks. One is the full stop and the other is exclamation mark. When do we use exclamation mark? We use an exclamation mark if you want to show that the words are being spoken with great feeling or emotions, then you earn exclamation mark. But basically imperative sentence end with a full stop only, okay, like this. And this is the form of imperative sentence. This sign refer to hidden subject. Hidden subject in imperative sentence, we already know that you, but because it is an imperative sentence, that's why you is left out. Base form, complement or object or something like that. And we also use the compound base form without subject again, but compound, you can use or in place of and here and complement like this. Does it make sense, everyone, after my explanation here? So imperative sentence end with either full stop or an exclamation mark. If you have any questions about imperative sentences, please write your question. I try my best to reply to all of yours. Well, we come to the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for watching my video, but don't forget to watch it every day. I usually say that a new video come out per day. When you meet one, you find it difficult to learn a lot of grammatical items because everything is taught in order. For example, today an imperative sentence, tomorrow, of course, another one. So don't miss it, okay? You spend around 7 to 15 minutes watching my video per day, you can understand a lot from my lessons. Okay, thank you very much. See you later. Bye-bye.